You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your past said. Boy, you got a friend in me.
Practice these things and then yeah, you got a friend in me. And then I'm going to read the scripture lesson for today, which is Luke chapter 17, verses 5 through 6, which is, the apostle said to the Lord, increase our faith. The Lord replied, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can say this to a mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it would obey you. Yeah, it's all. Hello everyone, I'm Ava. I hope you guys are having fun at Junior Night so far. Today, can you hear me? Okay. Today I'm going to talk about how we can increase our faith. So I'm going to begin by discussing what Amy just read, Luke 17, verses 5 through 6. So the apostle said to the Lord, increase our faith. And the Lord said, if you have faith like a grain of mustard seed, you can say this to a mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the seed, and it would obey you. In this story, the apostles, after listening to God discuss the characteristics of true followers and the candidates for kingdom of God, start questioning whether they possess those traits. They worry that they don't have the amount of faith they need to be a good or true follower, so they ask God to increase their faith. The apostles, as in the first teachers of the gospel, don't think that they have enough faith to be worthy of God's love. And to that, God says, and I'm paraphrasing here, even with the faith the size of a grain of mustard seed, which is like an unbeliever, you can do humanly impossible things. Now, that's not to say that because we're all at APA and celebrating our faith, that we're all going to get superpowers. That would be cool. However, it is saying that the smallest increase in faith can truly change someone's life. If you know me, you know that sometimes I overthink things. And with this overthinking, I usually find myself asking the question, why? Why is something that everyone asks themselves a lot, probably, and it's a way to expand on situations and usually act as a catalyst for a lot of other questions. A seed, if you will. But I found myself asking it a lot. It started when I was younger, and I would ask myself stuff like, why does my name start with an E when it sounds like an A? And then I would ask my mom, and she'd just say, oh, I just like the letter E better. And I was like, oh, okay. And then I made it through elementary school and then middle school, and occasionally I'd ask some questions like, why is this person being so mean to me? Or, why am I taking Texas history when people that live in California don't have to take California history? Anyways, the cycle of me asking why continued. And for instance, right before I started writing this, I was actually asking the question, why do I have to take the ACT tomorrow? It's literally so dumb. The question why has been with me since I was a kid, and I can see myself asking it for a very long time. There is one time, however, where I found myself asking it a lot more than usual. If you don't know this, sophomore year was literally my least favorite grade ever. This isn't to scare the freshmen. Most of my friends really liked it, actually. It was just terrible. So it started this summer when my older sister left for college, leaving me as an only child for the first time in my entire existence. I'm really close with both my sisters, and so this was something I've been dreading for years. The night before she left, I asked myself a lot of questions like, what am I even going to do? How am I supposed to just move on? And most importantly, why? And then I went to school and I found myself asking similar questions like, why am I taking chemistry? Or why am I still in theater? I don't like it. Tabitha, and the amount of why circulating around my head only increased. Like I said, not a good year for me. Finally, I had finished sophomore year, and one day I was sitting in my room when my mom walked in, and she goes, hey, do you want to go to APA? And to that question, I responded with, why? I had gone to this church since I was really little, like I was baptized here, however, I was never super involved in the programs here. Anyways, this time when I asked the question, why, I wasn't met with a downpour of a ton of other questions, instead, I was only met with one, why not? I truly believe that this particular why was my mustard seed. Instead of the amount of questions I had expanding, my faith did. Soon I went to APA, and then Sunday school, and then small group. And each time I went to Sunday school or a church service or any sort of church thing, I could feel my faith increasing. When the apostles asked God to increase their faith, he said that with even the amount or the tiniest amount of faith, each one of them could do otherwise impossible things. If you had asked me last year, in the chaos of everything going on, if I thought of myself where there was a time where I would never say why every day, I don't know if I'd believe you. But since APA, I found myself asking why significantly less. I think the decision I made to come to APA was about the size of a mustard seed in comparison to the timeline of my life, but it created something I would have deemed impossible a year ago. Remember, God doesn't need any of us to have the most amount of faith ever recorded to work magic in our lives. We can expand our faith and our lives with just a little seed.